This song is basically, it was just drums and those chords for the first, like, 6 months of demo. Because, to be honest, when we write a song, it's all just about, like, something super simple. Then if it doesn't feel right,
we just leave it. We just don't ever touch it again.
Yeah. And yeah, this song was, it was just that melody that you can hear
on the guitar.
And I was like, this is sick. And I, like, rendered that demo and sent it to management. They're like, that's awesome. When's the full song going to be done? I was like, this is all I've got. Yeah. I don't even know what to do for the rest. Mm. So we came in here with Jara, and it was just hard to get it all meshing together because the first demo had this just super whack chord that just threw everything out. We really liked it. We didn't want to let go. We wanted to make it work, but it just wouldn't happen. So we had to forget about it. But like the song just came together from that point. And once we made that decision, everything flowed nicely, and it just felt super gratifying.
Our sound design is very simple. Like we don't put too much thought in like into making complicated sounds. It's just more like how they work together.
We use a lot of vintage synths, and they're all just like 70s and 80s synthesizers.
They help like ground music because they're all like kind of FM based, which have an overtone system that make things sound more natural.
It's all about trying to find like a good middle point between sort of what's synthesized and what's real. And yeah, we try to blend that and kind of blur the lines a bit, which kind of is the core idea of our album, was just blurring lines between digital and like analog and what's, sounds cool.
So that was A Million Times, like one of our hardest labors of love on this album. I hope you guys enjoyed like
hearing about how we wrote it and just a general breakdown of what made A Million Times.